This game is not suitable for children or those who are easily disturbed. Hey everyone, this is DaphTeet, and today's the episode where Doki Doki Literature Club really starts. So yeah, we're just gonna get into it. What did they say the safe Bible was called? Square? Okay, I read the whole thing in the last episode except for this part that was overlapping. Let's just get into it. I see an annoying girl running toward me from the distance, waving her arms in the air like she's totally oblivious to any attention she might draw to herself. That girl's my neighbor and good friend since we were children. You know, the kind of friend you'd never see yourself making today, but it just kind of works out because you've known each other for so long. We used to walk to school together on days like this, but starting around high school, she would oversleep more and more frequently and I'd get tired of waiting up, so I just wouldn't. It's Mona Yuri! Wait, is it zooming in? It's an ordinary school day like any other. Mornings are usually the worst, being surrounded by couples, in friend groups, and social people walking to school together. Meanwhile, I've always walked to school alone. I always tell myself it's about time I meet some girls or something like that, but I have no motivation to join any clubs. I'm perfectly content just getting my in the average while spending my free time on games and anime. There's always the anime club, but it's not like there would be any girls in it anyway. Zoom. The school day's as ordinary as ever, and it's over before I know it. After I pack up my things, I stare blankly at the wall, looking for an ounce of motivation. Clubs. There really aren't any that interest me. Besides, most of them would probably be way too demanding for me to want to deal with. I guess I have no choice but to start with the anime club. DaphTeet? What's that? Monika? Oh my goodness, I totally didn't expect to see you here! It's been a while, right? Yeah, it has. Monika smiles sweetly. We do know each other. Well, we rarely talk. We're aware of each other's presence. But we were in the same class last year. Monika was probably the most popular girl in class. Smart, beautiful, athletic. Basically, completely out of my league. So having her smile at me so genuinely feels a little... What'd you come in here for anyway? Oh, I've just been looking for some supplies to use for my club. Do you know if there's any construction paper in here? Or markers? I guess you could check the closet. You're in the debate club, right? About that! No. I actually quit the debate club.
Really? You quit?
Yeah. To be honest, I can't stand all the politics around the major clubs. It feels like nothing but arguing about the budget and publicity and how to prepare for events. I'd much rather take something I personally enjoy and make something special out of it. In that case, what club did you decide to join? Actually, I'm starting a new one. A literature club!
Literature? That sounds kind of dull. How many members do you have so far?
You're really gonna make me say it, aren't you? It's kind of embarrassing, but there are only three of us so far. It's really hard to find new members for something that sounds so boring.
Well, I can see that.
But it's really not boring at all, you know? Literature can be anything. Reading, writing, poetry. I mean, one of my members even keeps her manga collection in the club room. Because manga is literature.
Wait, really?
Yeah, it's funny, right? She always insists that manga is literature, too. I mean, she's not wrong, I guess. And besides, a member's a member, right?
Did Monika say she?
Aw, yeah, it's time for some girls.
Hey, DaphTeet. By any chance, are you still looking for a club to join?
I mean, I guess so, but...
In that case... Is there any chance you could do me a big favor? I won't ask you to join, but I kind of will. If you could at the very least visit my club, it would make me really happy. Please?
Well, I guess I have no reason to refuse.
Besides, how could I ever refuse someone like Monika?
Sure, I guess I could check it out.
Ah, awesome! You're really sweet, DaphTeet, you know that?
It's nothing, really.
Shall we go, then? I'll look for the materials another time. You're more important.
And thus, today marks the day I sold my soul to Monika and her irresistible smile.
And this is the part where we find a body. Classroom door. I'm back! And I brought a guest with me.
Ah! I said I wouldn't be scared by this, but like, seriously.
Huh? A guest?
Seriously, you brought a boy?
This is the second time I've told you, it's my lesbian haircut.
Way to kill the atmosphere.
Don't be mean, Natsuki. But anyway, welcome to the club, DaphTeet.
Well, all words escape me in this situation. This club is full of incredibly cute girls.
So, let me guess. You're Monika's boyfriend, right?
Girlfriend?
Stop.
Oh, I can touch the screen. Poke.
What?
No, I'm not.
Natsuki.
Anyway, this is Natsuki, energetic as usual. This is Yuri, the vice president.
It's nice to meet you.
Yuri, who appears comparably more mature and timid, seems to have a hard time keeping up with someone like Natsuki.
Yeah, it's nice to meet both of you.
So I ran into DaphTeet in a classroom and she decided to come check out the club. Isn't that great?
Wait, Monika! Didn't I tell you to let me know in advance before you brought anyone new? I was gonna, well, you know.
Sorry. I didn't forget that, but it just happened to run into her. In that case, I should at least make some tea, right? So, I know you didn't really plan on coming here, but we'll make sure you feel right at home, okay? As president of the Literature Club, it's my duty to make the club fun and exciting for everyone.
I'm surprised there aren't more people in the club yet.
It must be hard to start a new club. You could put it that way. Not many people are interested in putting out all the effort to start something brand new, especially when it's something that doesn't grab your attention, like literature. You have to work hard to convince people that you're both fun and worthwhile. But it makes school events like the festival that much more important. I'm confident that we can all really grow this club before we graduate. Right, Natsuki?
Well, I guess.
Natsuki reluctantly agrees. Such different girls, all interested in the same goal. Monika must have really worked hard just to find these two yahoos. Yuri returns to the table carrying a tea set. She carefully places a teacup in front of each vest before sitting down in the teapot in the middle. You keep a whole ass tea set in this classroom? Don't worry, the teachers gave us permission. After all, doesn't a hot cup of tea help you enjoy a good book?
No.
So, DaphTeet, what kinds of things do you like to read?
Well, considering how little I've read these past few years, I don't really have a good way of answering that.
Manga? I mutter quietly to myself, half joking. Natsuki's head suddenly perks up, her neck snaps! Oh wait, we're not at that part yet. Anyway, what about you, Yuri?
Well, let's see. Yuri traces the rim of her teacup with her finger.
My favorites are usually novels that build deep and complex fantasy worlds. The level of creativity and craftsmanship behind them is amazing to me. And telling a good story in such a foreign world is equally impressive.
Yuri goes on, clearly passionate about her reading.
Like you, stories with deep psychological elements usually immerse me as well.
Isn't it amazing how a writer can so deliberately take advantage of your own lack of imagination to completely throw you for a loop?
Yes, I've heard that, Yuri. Anyway, I've been reading a lot of horror lately.
Funny, so have I. It's called This Game. I read a horror book once.
Oh. Superior horror is often very successful at changing the way you look at the world, if only for a brief moment.
Like, I hate horror. It's scary.
Oh, why is that?
I just told you it's scary!
That's right. You usually like to write about cute things, don't you, Natsuki?
What? What gives you that idea?
You left a piece of scrap paper behind at the... I gotta read that again. You left a piece of scrap paper behind last club meeting. It looked like you were working on a poem called...
Don't say it out loud! And give that back!
Fine.
Natsuki, you write your own...
Wait, no, wrong voice.
Natsuki, you write your own poems?
Well, I guess sometimes. Reminds me of that vine where he's like, nor do you ever pee yourself.
Sometimes. Anyway, why do you care?
I think that's impressive. Like, I can't poet for shit.
Why don't you share them sometime?
No.
Natsuki averts her eyes.
You wouldn't like them.
Do you have writing experience too, Yuri? Maybe if you share some of your work, you can send an example and help Natsuki feel comfortable enough to share hers.
What? Yuri. We all sit in silence for a moment. Staring contest!
Hey, I just got an idea! How about this? Let's all go home and write a poem of our own. Then, next time we meet, we'll all share them with each other. That way, everyone is even. I thought it was a good idea.
Well, I think you're right, Monika. We should probably start finding activities for all of us to participate in together. Hold on, there's still one problem.
Yeah, what's that?
Now that we've reached the most important topic, I bluntly come forth with what's been on my mind the entire time. I never said I would join this club. I lose my train of thought. All three girls stare back at me with dejected eyes.
But
I'm sorry, I thought.
You suck!
Eh? Girls exchange glances before Monika turns back to me.
I guess I need to tell you the... Whoops, wrong voice. I guess I need to tell you the truth, DaphTeet. The thing is, you don't have enough members yet to form an official club.
You really are using logic on me?
We need 4. And I've been trying really, really hard to find new members. And if we don't find one more before the festival...
Well... I'm defenseless against these girls. Okay, I've decided then. I'll join the literature club.
DaphTeet, I'm so happy. We can become an official club now. Thank you so much for this. You're really amazing. I'll do everything I can to give you a great time, okay?
Thanks, I guess.
Okay, everyone! I think with that, we can officially end today's meeting on a good note. Everyone remember tonight's assignment. Write a poem to bring to the next meeting so we can all share.
Monika looks over at me once more.
DaphTeet, I look forward to seeing how you express yourself.
Yeah. You've unlocked a special poem. Would you like to read it? Just say yes. I can't convince myself to go to therapy when I'm the happiest I've ever been. I'd rather keep this up until they blow my cover and someone takes me to the emergency room and dies. Okay, just pick words. This seems cool. Unrestrained. Is that something which? Sugar. Sadness. Tragedy. Doki Doki. Infallible.
Pink.
Strawberry. Frightening. I'm waiting for one of those glitch words to show up and I just can't relax! Incongruent.
Email.
Comfort. Judgment. Isn't there supposed to be an E in there?
Playground.
Oof. Cheeks. Skirt. Whistle. Rose. Daydream. Is trying to copy J-Hope. Okay, that was short. And I'm already not liking this, but I'm gonna play it anyway because I am a brave woman. Thank you guys for watching. Okay, be sure to like and subscribe, and I'll see you next week where I torture myself even more with this game. It is not cool anymore. This is not for grits and giggles. Abort! Abort! And also, one quick thing. There's the poster, the Sayori hanging poster everyone's talking about. Okay, now I'm gonna end the video.